You ever hear the expression my day, right? Women's day or men's day or whatever? Funny thing is that most likely as an alien or whatever I am, I recently asked myself, why is it called my day, right? Because I've also lived in this concept that, you know, tomorrow is my day, right? But no other day is than my day, right? Well, people celebrate one's day, well, that calendaristic day when they are born. Funny thing is, well, you are only born once, and obviously you'll only die once, so technically those are the important dates. What people are celebrating is, well, the aging of the physical body. Now, the point about perception is that, you know, people have been conditioned to believe in so many, you know, awkward things. Like, for example, the day. The day doesn't exist. It is just a perception. It is just something created because of, you know, cycles of the planet. But realistically speaking, there is no such thing as a day, right? But the more one entrenches themselves into meaning, the more they become enslaved by that point. That is why I usually don't have a sense of time, nor do I wear a watch anymore, nor do I simply feel that a day should be mine. A friend of mine told me a quote that, you know, every day is basically your day, right? But what is it that it is your day, right? What is it that it is men's day or women's day, right? Because if it is your own individual day, well, most likely on that calendaristic date you have been born, or it could be your name's date, aka a saint or something, well, bears the same name as you, right? So let's say if there's something like a Saint Rachel, or let's say something fictive, right, and your name is Rachel, then that would be your name's day, right? But your name is not yours, right? It was given to you, but, well, technically it's just a piece of meaning that most people have agreed upon. And you also have agreed, right? Just like everyone else has a name, because there is a collective agreement that that name temporarily belongs to them, right? Because the moment one leaves the physical body, that name will be simply irrelevant to them, right? If people only remember you by your name, well, you most likely lived life for nothing. If people remember you for some emotional attachments, well, probably you were a bit more different, right? But ultimately, it is the best if people remember you for your deeds, and hopefully for good deeds, right? When it comes to Women's Day and Men's Day, why is it that there actually needs to be such a day, right? This just goes to point towards separation. Because Men's Day is not just like, you know, anniversary, because men weren't born that day, right? And Women's Day is the same. Women weren't born that day. It's just a collective agreement upon a day in which theoretically people should celebrate something. But each day should be a celebration because you live each day. I see people going to shops on the 14th of February because they call it the Valentine's Day. They call it the Day of Love. And they feel like in that day you need to struggle a bit more, you know, to showcase the others that your so-called relationship is not a relationship, and, you know, it's basically not no codependency. It's, you know, something more real than it actually is, right? So many people believe that these days are, you know, or at least should be more significant. If you can afford it, right? Because most people either financially can't or emotionally, and, you know, through programming they don't allow themselves to. Every day is a celebration because it is said that 250,000 people die every single day. So it means that many people don't wake up a certain day or simply fall dead, because when that moment happens, it doesn't matter where you are. You simply leave a body behind. Now, the point about this is so many people leaving, one should become grateful, you know, and more still about the life that they have within. Because what's ticking is technically, you know, the time of the physical body. Every day passes and, well, only the time of the physical body passes, but one day it shall be left behind. So it's not important whether you celebrate a woman's day or a men's day. this is just a 3D conscious awareness, right? It is just a kind of separation. Because ultimately, it doesn't matter whether you are a man or a woman, you're still shit in the same eyes of society. Because this society has been shaped to worship things and, you know, to use people. As a human, you're nothing else than a battery that is supposed to simply feed a system, right? This so-called matrix, until you simply can no longer, and well, that's when you are getting disposed. Because being a battery that supports a system is the same thing as being a brick that supports a wall, right? When you are a piece that is not, you know, unique in its own way because so you choose, the point is when you break, you are easily replaceable because, well, that's the purpose of all bricks. A brick breaks, it's easily replaceable, right? So why would I focus on celebrating a specific day? Each and every day is technically my day because I'm living it, right? Each one of us lives those days, right? And well, they should live as consciously and as presently as possible. So the funny thing is, why should you focus on Men's Day or on Women's Day? Is it that because you should feel more womanly or more manly that day? How will you actually do that? If you want to show others that you are manly, why don't you be yourself? And you don't have to do that in a specific day. Because ultimately, for this society, you're still a piece of shit. That's how society has shaped you to view of yourself, right? And of everyone else. And if everyone else views themselves as a piece of shit, they will also view everyone else. Because ultimately, if something bothers you, everyone else will bother you. So if you think you're a piece of shit, you will think about everyone that they're a piece of shit. So the funny thing is, everyone will consider everyone else a piece of shit. And guess what? Unfortunately, that's the reality today. So why invest in all this misery? Because ultimately, you are what you are, okay? It's not important who you think you are. You are what you are. You are a, let's say, piece of life who experiences this process, right, of awareness in a physical body. No other explanations needed because the mind cannot ever comprehend the such. But the point is, every day is special. And one day we shall all die, as a quote was said, right? But not in any other of the days. So why not enjoy life as it is? There is no importance for a Men's Day or an International Women's Day. It's not that anything special happens in that day. It's just that you're still that. You're still a piece of shit in the eyes of this sick society, right? Until we change it, well, until people wake up more and more, as it's slowly happening, but surely. The point is, people apparently don't realize the futility of such things. All this being said, you are appreciated. Take care of yourselves. Ferengian Board signing out.